St. John to Copeland's camp. It's done. The radio tower's locked down, and I've restored your radio uplink.
Copy that. You may not see the value in St. John, but radio-free Oregon is the only thing keeping us from turning into savages.
Now, Cope, the only thing keeping us from turning into savages is about 9 square meals. Try going hungry for 3 days. There's no such thing as a starving patriot.
Well, sir, I hope to God you're wrong about that. Copeland out.
Radio Free Oregon. Jesus, what have I done?
Boozman, you awake? I'm heading to that camp you spotted north of the mountain.
I heard gunshots. Might be an ambush camp.
I'll find out when I get there. Deacon out!
Men coming!
Booze man, you were right. They set up under railroad tracks.
You killed every one of the sons of bitches.
That was kind of the plan.
Deacon out.
Burn, you asshole.
That's the last of them. Stay the hell off O'Leary Mountain. Boozer, it's done. Squatter camp. They won't be doing any more killing on O'Leary Mountain.
Good. Deke, I should have been there. To help, I mean, I...
Just rest up, Booze man. Rest up. We're riding north as soon as your arm heals. You got that?
Yeah, I hear you. Boozer out.
Yeah, I'm gonna ride up to the cemetery and see if I can find Leon's stash.
Sorry. What was that?
Rest up, Boozer. We're heading north as soon as you can ride.
North. Yeah.
Deke! Sick and tired of drifters coming in my camp, killing folk like we were out in the shit.
What's going on, Cope?
A man come in, drugged out of his mind, shot the place up, then he just took off. Lanny said his bike's got a red tank on it, and he was wearing some kind of motocross helmet, silver.
Okay, if I go now, I might be able to catch up to him.
I want him alive, Deke.
Alive?
Alive. You catch this man, and radio me. Fetch him and hang the bastard right from that limb. It's time we start showing these drifter sons of bitches that we have law and order in this camp. No offense meant to yourself.
I'm taken. I'll find him. Man, no. You know, I wouldn't ride north without you.
Yeah, I know. I just kind of out of it.
Oh, third degree burns will do that to you.
Yeah. So, take care of Alvarez, you know. Deke, it means a lot to me.
I'll take care of her, Boozer. Just get some rest. Deacon out.
Soldiers down. Well, we're all homeless now. living in the wilderness in the way of our forebears. The feds used to think we needed their welfare and handouts to survive. We showed them how wrong they were. What we need now is a strong will, determination, and trust in each other. The feds were never gonna give us that. And you? You want our trust? You gotta earn it. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
That's great! Yeah, Radio Free Oregon is on the air once again! Oh, God, what have I done?
Okay, let's take a look around. Which way?
Back on track.
This is it. Checking out. Still got this.
Hey, Deke, you there? Let's see.
You were saying something?
Hey, Deke, you there? I was thinking about heading down to that logging camp and clear out those nests. But someone freaks out here.
Boozer, no, no, you're gonna get yourself killed. You gotta wait till you're whole, brother. I'm over here anyway, so I'll take care of the nest, okay?
Yeah, okay. Thanks, Deke.
Deke, wait till tonight. There'll be fewer freaks inside those nests. Or take them out while it's still light out. There'll be more of them, but they won't be as strong. Yeah, nice bunch of rapists, thieves, and murderers. What you doing out here, huh? You looking for your next easy target?
son of a bitch!